If you're an aspiring athlete, musician, writer, and keep running into roadblocks, take a page from the book of Marcellus Wiley. With hard work and dedication, he made it to the NFL and played 10 years. This after he was told in high school that he would never make it. I caught up with him at a Nike combine as he was talking to young athletes.
Everything good?
Yeah, man.
Well, man, I just want to say, first of all, congratulations to you guys for coming out here and working at your own skills, working at your own craft. I went to Westchester and St. Monica's. I see a Dorsey hat right there. I'm from this area, man. I was born, raised in Compton, went to schools around here and was told that I couldn't make it to the NFL. I was told that I was too small. I was told I wasn't a good enough athlete. I was a high school safety and high school running back. I was 6 feet, 180 pounds, ran like a 4.8, 4.9. You know, okay. But that's where I was at that time. And at that same time, I was on a team with a lot of guys who went to Division I schools, big schools, and were told that they were going to the NFL, and I wasn't. And then I went to Columbia University, which is an Ivy League school. I wanted to put my education first and have a safety net. Just in case football didn't work out, I would have an opportunity of success because of my education. From there, I start getting a little bigger, a little faster, a little stronger. Why? Because I remember when I was a 4.9 player, they told me I couldn't make it. So I kept working on it. Well, that's where you guys are right now today. You're going to be told where you are right now. And some of you guys are going to be told something great. And some of you guys are going to be told something not so great. But it's about improving in that race, running your own race, improving your own skills. Because believe me, after I graduated Columbia, they told me there's no way you're going to the NFL. But out of the Ivy League, I went to the NFL, played 10 years, made Pro Bowls, and enjoyed my career. Now I'm in the media at ESPN, and I get to talk about all kinds of players, athletes, guys like you guys, one day who are going to be in the NFL. But it's not always about the NFL, guys. It's about life skills, it's about character, and what the game of football can give to you as well. So take it from me, a guy who never thought he would ever make it to the league, never thought he would be in front of a guy, a group of young men like yourself, telling you about my story, that you guys can make it happen as well. So get your spark rating today, and remember, it's just a measurement of where you are now. Continue that race, continue to work hard, and good luck to you all. Thanks, baby.
Give it up, guys. Give it up for
We will also be having our education.
Feed off each other's energy, stay together. We're all here for the same reason, fellas. Alright? We're here to run fast and jump high. Let's work hard together. Do work on three. One, two, three,
do work!
So what's going on here today?
You know what? We're out here for the Nike Spark Combine, and it's a football combine where high school athletes get opportunity to get their spark rating, which is going to measure things like their 40-yard dash, the vertical jump, their agility, and to see where they rank themselves amongst other high school football players. So it's exciting to see that these kids are out here afternoon, not watching cartoons, but working at their craft. So we're going to see if these guys leave here smiling or frowning, but it's just a benchmark for where you are right now, and it's a long race ahead.
You grew up in a rough area,
mm-hmm.
South LA,
mm-hmm.
It's always on the news, not always for the positive stuff.
Yeah.
How did you make it? How would these kids make it?
You know what? You make it by, first of all, knowing who you are, knowing what you want out of life, and then you won't listen to everything else or anyone else, because you're going to realize your own dreams, realize your own potential, and that's what I did. I didn't listen to the gangsters. I didn't listen to the drug dealers. I didn't care what they were saying, because they weren't saying what I was telling myself. I was telling myself, I'm getting out the neighborhood, and by any means necessary, through this grass and these cleats, I'm going to find a way out of here. And my education as well, going to Columbia University, Ivy League school, did wonders for me, and it provided me with a security blanket just in case the NFL didn't work out. And now, you know, I'm enjoying all the fruits of that labor and really loving it.
But you came back.
Oh, yeah, got to come back. This is home, you know. You know, I'm always going to be an L.A. guy. I'm always going to be around this community, around the neighborhood, and always making sure that these kids, especially when they hit that fork in the road, do I keep working hard and trying to realize my goals and my dreams, or do I sit back and say, you know, let me just fall into the traps of my hood? I'm going to be there always to be influenced to tell them to do the right thing.
Cool. Thank you very much.
My dog. Always.
So whatever you do, give it your all and believe in yourself, but always have a backup plan. In Los Angeles, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting